tell you that.
Welcome back, guys. Today's smelting day. We're doing a large 500 gram assay in this large graphite crucible today. We got our cons all mixed up with our fluxes. We gotta mix and congeal everything perfectly, and then we're gonna add it to the graphite crucible. Once I get it all homogeneous, we'll add it to the crucible. I'm also gonna add the contents of this pan. We have a whole bunch of sulfides in here, some hematites, some pyrites, a little bit of gold, little bit of copper. Now I tried to pull out all the copper BBs because when I coupel the lead button from smelting, the copper tends to draw a little bit of gold with it down into the cupel. So I picked out all the visible copper I could see. So now that we got our flux and ore all mixed up, we're gonna prep the crucible. You can see all the graphite's burnt off on the outside of this crucible, but we're still retaining graphite on the inside. So hopefully we get a couple more fires out of this, but I'm gonna place this in here and we're gonna charge it up. And since the volume of the crucible is already so high, I'm not gonna use the railroad spike today. I'm gonna use a big old piece iron rod from an old screen deck so it'll take up less volume. And we're gonna just push this down in here. And hopefully that will help oxidize some of the pyrites out of the ore. All right, now we're gonna turn on the gas, light the forge, heat it up, heat up the crucible, and get smelting. So I'm gonna let the gas out, lower the pressure, light it, and off we go. Bye. Woo! So I'm gonna open up the carburetor, let some more air into the furnace. When I do that, you'll notice flame will condense down with more oxygen, burn hotter, much smaller, and it'll turn into a jet roar. Here it comes. Since this charged the crucible has a whole lot of soda ash in it, I'm gonna bring up the temperature in the furnace slowly so the soda ash doesn't boil and froth up over the edge. So we're slowly ramping up the temperature on the furnace. This is our giant cone mold. This thing's a behemoth, but it's actually the perfect size for this crucible or one size higher. So once our smelt's complete, I'm gonna pick out the crucible with these tongs, place it down on the ground, get my pouring tongs, pick up the crucible. I'm gonna come over here and gently pour all the slag and precious metals into the cone mold. And right down there in the bottom is where we're gonna get our big old lead button and hopefully all of our gold and other precious metals. Violent frothing and bubbling is done in the crucible, we'll be able to crank up the temperature. We're at full blast, full temp now. All the reaction and bubbling's over, so we're gonna give it a stir. Fire's out. It's time to pull a crucible and pour.
Whoa, baby. Oh.
That is hot stuff right there. Look at that. Cover this up. Oh, that's blazing. Silver colored skim you see on top is graphite from the crucible shedding graphite. Well, as you saw, we had a little bit of a pour malfunction. Our crucible is on its last legs. It's having a hard time here, and we still got a whole bunch of metal, gold colored, silver colored, and lead in the bottom of the crucible that didn't want to pour out. Well, look at that. This is the bottom of the crucible after I poured it. There's like a half gram BB that's gold colored down there. There's one in the slag. There were a few more as well. And for whatever reason, the gold's not wanting to be released from the crucible. Here's the pour cooling, and you can see there's a gold BB on top. That big one right there. And then there's quite a few others. You got some gold color right there. And all throughout, from the last bit of the pour, out of the bottom of the crucible, some of this gold's not congealing, and it's ending up on the top of this slag pile. So we're gonna have to troubleshoot this to get it figured out. So we'll have to take a closer look at that and possibly refire the slag, dump this mold, and see what we got. There it goes. Here's our button. It's pretty big. Our slag button. There's our lead right there. But we do have a few residual. Woo, that's hot. I'll let that cool a little bit more. So here's our lead button. We're gonna go ahead and clean that up and cupel it. And I think I'm gonna refire the slag. Take two, refiring the slag. So we got our second fire going. It's blazing, rolling, white hot this round. Crazy hot. It's still boiling, giving off a little bit of gases, so we got a little bit longer to go. But it's a little frustrating because I did two test fires on this ore before this. The exact same weight of concentrates, the exact same fluxes. And the first two smelts on this ore went off without a hitch. Perfect pours, perfect buttons, cupelled nicely, and I got a good baseline to go off. Holy moly, look at that. Nice clean pour that time. Beauty. Beauty.
Woo.
Nice clean pour that time. Beauty. So we got a nice clean pour that time. It's fantastic. The slag is cooling. Here's the crucible. I believe it's its last fire. Heard a lot of crackling and popping. And it's still blazing hot, as is the furnace. Our second pour. I think it's cool enough. You can see it's really glassy this time around. Black, clear, and glassy. That's good. Hopefully we won't have a matte layer down on the bottom. Came out nice and clean. Here again is the button. Look at that thing. So we got solid glass up here, which is good. Hopefully we won't have a matte layer. And we'll have a nice clean button down at the bottom. Still pretty darn hot. Ooh, we got a big button that time. Look at that. That is huge. That is way more, that looks like way more collector lead than we put in. So we might have a pile of gold and silver in this. We got a couple straggler BBs that didn't congeal into the button. We'll keep those down here for later processing. Look at that. That thing is freaking huge. That is massive. I'm going to go weigh that real quick. We still got some slag on there, but we got some kind of weird secondary layer on the bottom. You can see lead, and then we got a second maybe precious metal button down here. Ooh, that's hot. Somebody go give that a quick weigh. Holy cow, this thing weighs 246 grams. I put in 99.5 grams of lead. So that's like 146.5 grams of extra metal from somewhere. And if this is all gold and silver, we're definitely in business. But like I said, you can see that line, a solid lead, and then a third way up, we still have slag, there's metal underneath it, but that's highly curious. I guess it's possible that some slag coated the bottom, flash cooled, and then we got a secondary layer. But this is a massive freaking honking button. That thing's unbelievable. If we got 146 grams of precious metals, oh my gosh, are we in business. Time will tell. You know, we got to coop all these. I'm going to have to get a bigger cupel because that's a hell of a lot of lead. And we're just going to go from there. This is unbelievable. Let's take a look at the rest of the slag. Super brittle and glassy, which is good. So I think we got a good smelt. You can see it basically looks like obsidian. It's ready to shatter in my hand. I'm not seeing any sort of matte layer. Whoa. Look at that, it's pure glass obsidian. So adding that extra borax at the end definitely helped. Ooh, that's hot. Wow. That was a much better melt than the first time around. There we got a little silver ball. We'll let this cool and inspect it. Ooh, there's a little blobblet that didn't make it into the button. You can see right there. It's definitely lead. There's a little bit of brassy and gold tinge to it as well. I'm not sure where all this metal's coming from. I mean, look at this. We got more than double the amount of collector. So we definitely picked up some PMs, probably a little bit of residual lead from the previous firings. However, that still doesn't make up what we have here. So this is gonna be really interesting to coupel and see what we got. All right, guys, we got the cupelling furnace out. We're gonna warm up the cupel in the furnace. We're gonna warm it up to temperature around 1700 degrees Fahrenheit. That is pretty darn hot. So we're gonna load the cupel. Once it's nice and warmed up, we're gonna load our lead button, cupel away the lead, leaving us with a precious metal bead. This bead is from the first pour where we had some technical difficulties. I don't expect there to be a whole lot of gold or silver in it. However, the second bead, when we refired the slag, oh my gosh, that bead is, what was it, 146 grams heavier than the metal we started with. So it certainly picked something up. It'll be really exciting to see what we got in there. Here's the cupel. Here's the button. Load it on up. Right there. She's done. Let's see that it's gold. Oh, I really need both hands for this. Shoot. There it is. Solid gold. It's a thing of beauty right there. There she be, guys. There's our first prill of gold. This one has a very gold sheen to it, so I think there's a low percentage of silver. But there it is in that first misfire. Boy, am I curious to see what's gonna come out of that second one.